Good morning and welcome back to another exciting Sunday with Delicia and myself.
Hello everyone, great to be with you all again today.
I can't wait to see today who our hero of faith is.
Oh, I'm very excited as well. I'm looking really forward to that.
Well, to get us going, I think we should all play a game that we all do definitely love.
Yes, we all enjoy playing this game that Pastor Michelle has chosen. I like this game.
It's stand up, sit down.
Stand up, sit down, stand up.
So we're going to get some exercise while we do this one.
That's a good idea. Not too many, otherwise I'll get too stiff.
We don't want you to be feeling any stiff because today's hero is a lovely one.
It definitely is.
So let's start with our first question. So if you think the right answer is standing, then you're going to stand in your lounge or your kitchen or wherever you are. And if you think it's sitting, then you're going to take a seat. And we're going to see who is right and who is wrong. All right, so for the first question, I want you to stand up if there are 30 books in the New Testament, or sit down if you think there are 27 books in the New Testament.
30 to 27.
What do you think it is? Is it standing or is it sitting?
What do you think,
children? Give us a
thumbs
up if it's a standing and give us a thumbs down if you think it's sitting. So Delicia, do you know which is the correct one? Should they be standing or sitting?
I do, Pastor Michelle. They should be sitting.
There's 27 books in the New Testament.
That is
so
correct.
Well done if you got it right. So the second question let's have a look at is stand up if you think Joseph defeated Goliath, or sit down if you think David defeated Goliath.
Joseph, David.
So give us a thumbs up if you think it was Joseph. Give us a thumbs down if you think it was David.
But you also must be standing or sitting, whichever one you think it is.
Exactly. So the correct answer is all those that are
sitting.
David defeated Goliath.
Can I do the next one?
You can go for it.
Right. So are you ready? It's stand up if there are 13 commandments that Moses spoke of, or sit down if there are 10 commandments. Stand up,
13,
sit down. I think they know this one. This is really not a difficult one.
No.
Okay, so are you standing or are you sitting?
Comment below. Standing,
so Pastor Michelle, what should they be doing?
They should all be sitting. There was only 10 commandments. Unless, you know, someone decided to add a few extras, but
the
original is
10.
All right, are you ready for the next one?
I'm ready.
Okay, so stand up if Noah built the ark out of gopher wood. Go for the wood.
Okay.
And sit down if Noah built the ark out of pine wood.
Pine wood.
So standing for gopher wood, sitting for pine.
Gopher, pine. I wonder how many know this one.
It's quite a hard one. You might not know it, but you can guess. So let us know. Are you giving us a thumbs up or are you sitting with a thumbs down?
Okay. So and it should be
standing
because it's gopher wood.
Gopher wood. You want to do the next one?
I will do that. Okay, so stand up if the book of Revelation is the last book in the New Testament, last book, Revelation, or sit down if the book of Revelation is the last book in the Old Testament.
Oh, now I hope they get this one right.
They should, because they've been learning the books of the Bible.
They have been.
Yeah.
So do you think they're standing or do you think they're sitting?
I think, what do you think they should be doing, I think?
Are you ready?
Okay, so it's the New Testament is standing, Old Testament is sitting for the book of Revelation.
So we start like this because we're going to make a decision.
Okay, so.
One, two, three.
Right, it's in the New Testament.
It should be standing.
Well done, everybody. Good.
Shall we do our memory verse?
Definitely memory verse time.
And our memory verse is found in Psalms 37, verse 23. And
where is Psalms?
It's in the Old Testament.
Like in the middle of your Bible.
Yeah. Okay. It's the easiest book to find.
Okay.
And you know what the scripture says?
Do tell us.
The steps of a man are established by the Lord when he delights in his way.
Wow, that's really good, hey?
So
our steps, where we go,
are
established by the Lord. Awesome.
Mm-hmm. So shall we pick what we're going to do for our memory verse?
Okay, I think you go first this time because I always choose the funny ones.
I hope we get rap. That was so much fun last
time. No, seriously.
let's see which one. Oh, we have to rhyme.
Now, how do you rhyme the words.
The steps of a man are established by the Lord when he delights in his way.
That's not really a rhyme.
What's
that's
that
almost a rhythm.
Oh, let's do rhythm then. Let's do
okay,
a rhythm.
Okay, we'll do a rhythm. Because it's difficult
then.
To rhyme it when it doesn't already
yeah.
rhyme.
Okay, let's
so
do a
let's
rhythm.
Make it a rhythm.
Okay, okay. Ready?
I'm ready. I'm going to follow your lead.
Okay. The steps of a man are established by the Lord when he delights in his way. Psalms 37, verse 23. I thought that sounds really nice.
It does. It was a good rhyme.
It was a good rhyme. Do you
well,
want to try
rhythm.
Now?
Rhythm. Okay, so I'll get one now. Okay, let's see what we have here. Hold your ears.
Well, that I can do.
I can do that one too. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right. So
where's your
really
ears, Delicia?
On the side of my head.
Oh, I'm just checking.
Yeah.
I'm just checking. You know, sometimes the kids tell us, don't tell us where the ears are.
No, because some of them
don't like to listen.
Want to use their
yeah.
ears.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, we're ready.
But not our impact children, they all use their ears.
They're listening to us today.
All right, let's go.
The steps of a man are established by the Lord when he delights in his way. Psalm 37, verse 23.
Good, so we had our ears wide open.
We had our ears wide open and we heard what God is saying to us.
Exactly. Great.
Wow, so I'm so excited. I brought along a couple of very cool things. So Delicia, today I brought along a couple of hats. You know, we sometimes wear a hat just to protect our head and protect us from the sun. And sometimes it's just like to wear it to look nice.
Mm-hmm, that's true.
But sometimes a hat can really identify a person in a job that they do or a position that they have.
That's
so
true.
I thought we could have a look at a couple of our hats that I brought along. Would that be okay?
Great, great. I'd like to. Would you like to look at those hats? A whole box of them.
We got
wow,
a box.
What have we got there?
So let's look at the first one. What do you think that one is?
What do you children think this one is? Who would wear a hat like this?
I can see somebody riding a horse and chasing the cows to move them into a place.
Yeah, so generally a cowboy or mm-hmm. a cowgirl would wear a hat like this.
But I've seen
they?
Some people just wear it for fun.
Yeah, some people just wear it for fun. But the cowboys and cowgirls wear it because it's their job.
It's
what they do.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I also found this one.
Oh, that's an interesting one.
Captain
a
on
captain.
It.
A captain.
This could
a captain
be
of a soccer team?
A captain of a boat, I would say.
Yeah,
like
not
a sailor.
A soccer team,
do you want to put that one on your head?
I don't know, should I?
You can be a captain.
How does it look?
It looks really cute.
I think it's a
thumbs
little
up
small.
If it looks cute.
Okay.
Alright. Delicia is the captain of a ship today.
Okay, so the cap mm-hmm. means this cap means that a person wearing it, their job is a captain.
Exactly. Okay. And if we have a look at this one, this could be like a sailor.
Okay, the sailor on the boat with the captain.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And, oh, I like this one.
Oh, yes. Okay.
That looks really nice. That's mm-hmm. normally for like a police officer.
Yes, that is
yeah.
true.
Mm-hmm. And the last one, which okay. is my real favorite one.
Yes.
Who do you think would wear this one
wear
as a job?
A crown as a job.
So normally, people that wear these are born into this position and sometimes they aren't really chosen okay. to do this one. But today, we're going to be talking about a queen. Would you like to put this one on?
Mm-hmm.
We're going to be talking about a queen who was one of God's heroes. Doesn't she look so good? She was born to wear one of those. And today we're going to just see how God's plan really was for this young lady. And she was chosen to be a queen of a very big country. Do you know what? When you have also been chosen to be a hero for God and that he has a royal plan for you. So let's go and have a look and see who is the royal plan for today that God chose to wear this kind of hat.
Yes, she was somebody, a lady, who was actually chosen for this position.
She was.
She wasn't born into it mm-mm. this time, but she was chosen.
So let's go and have a look.
You may know my story and know me as Esther. My cousin Mordecai raised me when I was just a child, after my parents died. He kept telling me that because of my beauty and loveliness, I could be the next queen. He said that I was special, unique, that God had created me for a purpose, and he had a special plan for my life. I never believed him because I was just a Jewish orphan. But I will never forget the day I heard the most surprising news. There is trouble in the palace. The king had ordered the queen to come appear before his guests, and she refused, flatly refused. The king is looking for a new queen. A notice was sent out to gather all the most beautiful girls in the kingdom. It so happened that I was one of those kept in the palace for a year, given beauty treatments and trained on how to meet the king. I will never forget how scared I was to meet the king. He had no idea I was a Jew. Mordecai told me to keep that a secret. I was just a plain girl, and I never wore the elaborate clothes that the others did. But I captured the king's heart, and he made me his new queen.
God called a simple fisherman to be a fisher of all men. God used this man to perform miracles big and small. God wanted every single person to know about his word. He asked a man to do his great works. The Holy Spirit that lived in these people lives in you. Great work. All we have to do is put our faith and trust in Him. Put your faith and trust in Him.
Being queen came with one privilege that I took advantage of. I could go wherever I wanted. And every day, I went to the palace gate to meet Mordecai, and every day, he was there. One day, Mordecai heard the guards whispering. They were planning the assassination of the king. He told me to speak to the king. The king appointed Haman as the prime minister. All the king's officials had to bow to him in reverence, but Mordecai refused. He said that because he was a Jew, he didn't have to. Haman was angry, but he decided rather than just punishing Mordecai, he would destroy all the Jews in the entire kingdom. Remember, the king didn't know I was a Jew, and so he agreed with Haman's plan. The king took off his own ring and gave it to Haman to seal the notice, which meant it was final and couldn't be changed. I was frantic. Women, children, young and old would be killed on the 28th day of February next year, and all their property would be given to those who killed them. Throughout the kingdom, there was great mourning and despair amongst the Jews, weeping and fasting at the king's decree. Immediately, Mordecai sent word to me that I must go and plead to the king for my people. I sent back a message saying, all the world knows that whoever enters the king's inner courts without his summons is doomed to die unless the king holds out his golden scepter. And The king hadn't called for me in over a month. Mordecai sent another message, which said, "Perhaps God allowed you to become queen for such a time as this. Try to save our people. Do not become silent, Hadassah." Hadassah is my real name, the name Mordecai would call me when he used to bounce me on his knee and tell me stories about Abraham and Moses. I was afraid, but I knew I would have to help my people, even if it cost my life. And I knew I couldn't do it myself. So I asked Mordecai to call a meeting with all the Jews in the kingdom. "Fast and pray for 3 days, and I will do the same. And then I will meet the king. If I die, then I die." Those were 3 long days. I was so uptight, I could hardly eat. But I prayed. Oh, I prayed like I had never prayed before. And then I dressed in my best royal robes, made myself look as beautiful as I could, and went to meet the king.
It has been such an interesting story about Esther and how she became queen. Mm-hmm. But you know, Esther didn't know what God's plan was for her in the very beginning, but she still trusted him because she served God. So I have a picture here. You see the picture, Pastor Michelle?
Sure.
And children, you see the picture? I wonder if you can see what this picture is of. Do you know what the picture is of? Can you see?
No, I can't see
it. It's difficult to see, isn't it? Because it's covered with all these little post-its. So I guess we need to start to remove the post-its to be able to see what the picture actually is of. Because we cannot see the full picture. In fact, we can't see any of the picture yet. Pastor Michelle, would you like to remove one or two of them?
I'm going to pull this one. I'm going to pull this one. Can I take one more?
I think you should. Do we know yet what the picture is?
No.
No. Okay, so we're going to have to start taking off some more. I think you're going to have to take all those maybe, Pastor
Michelle.
Can
I take all of those?
Do we know yet what the picture is?
No.
No. Still nothing. I wonder if you can guess what underneath the picture is.
Oh,
maybe that's starting to give you a clue.
There's something there.
Ah, there's something there that looks very interesting. Mm-hmm. But we still can't see the whole picture, can we? We still don't know what it's all about. Mm-hmm. You see, it's the same with us in our lives. We sometimes don't know what God's full plan is. I think keep taking the pictures off, Pastor Michelle. And we have to take a step at a time and trust God for what His full plan is for our lives. In the same as Esther, she didn't know what the full plan was that God had for her, but she had been listening to God and hearing what God was telling her to do. And her uncle Mordecai as well, he helped her hear what God's plan was for her.
When I hold it that way,
is that the way the pictures actually come? Are you starting to see what the picture is about?
I think we've
so Esther kept on doing what was right in God's sight and following after God's plan. Because the more and more she followed God and more time she spent learning about what God's plan was for her, the more she actually began to see the plan. And the plan was for her to become queen, to be wearing a crown. A crown for God, really, because after all, her plan was the plan that God had for her. She was chosen for such a time as this. That's what Mordecai said to her. "Don't you know that you are chosen for such a time as this?" In the same way with us, we don't always know the big picture God has for us in our lives, the big plan. But little by little, as we follow after Him and as we trust Him, we will start to see what His amazing plan is for us. Because each one of us has a royal plan because we are God's royal children. And God has that plan for us to be fulfilled in our lives. But we need to trust Him that He knows best.
That is so true.
Let us see now what happened next to Esther as she trusted God.
The king sat on his throne, scepter in hand. When I approached, a tense quiet filled the room. "What is it, Queen Esther?" asked the king. "Whatever you ask, I will give you, even half my kingdom." I asked, "If it pleases your majesty, would you and Haman join me for a banquet that I have prepared?" He burst out laughing, cutting the tension in the room. "Why, of course." He was always in the mood for wine and food. On the following day, the king and Haman came to dine. Again, over the wine, the king said, "What is it that you ask for? I will give you half the kingdom if you ask." This time, everything seemed right. I bowed deeply before the king and pleaded, "You know that I have never asked for anything for myself, your majesty. But if it pleases you, let me and my people live. An evil man is trying to kill us all. Please save us." The king could hardly believe his ears. "What is she talking about? And who is this man doing this terrible thing?" This was the moment. Would the king side with me or his prime minister? Silently, I pointed my finger. "He is. He is the man who will kill my people." The king turned white with rage and rose from the banquet and went to the gardens to think. When he returned, furious, he ordered that Haman would be hung in his own gallows. That is how I saved my people. I remembered the words of Mordecai. "Perhaps God allowed you to become queen for such a time as this."
Hello everyone, and welcome to our Impact Coffee Corner. So today we don't have one visitor, but we have a family. So can we welcome Pastor Sam, Pastor Pam, Joel and Anna?
Hello.
Hi everybody.
So we are so happy that you are here today because we really want to chat to you about heroes.
We are so glad to be here today.
So I want to find out from you, what do you think a hero is? Is a hero, before you start, somebody that needs something like this? Do you think that's what a hero is about?
A star.
A star?
Saving people.
Someone who's brave.
Someone who's brave.
Someone who's courageous.
Wow. So who is your hero?
My dad.
I think Pastor Sam needs this. Oh, my word. Can you pass it? I think, you know, because he's a hero.
Heavy. That looks heavy. Oh my God. It's heavy, Joel.
Oh,
we don't have the muscles.
We don't have the muscles.
Yeah. So guys, how do I look?
You look like a hero.
Yeah.
Joel, who's your hero?
God.
God?
My hero is Jesus.
Awesome.
And you know, we've been really learning about an amazing hero, and her name is Esther. What do you think makes her a hero?
Well, if you look at the story of Esther, she was a Jewish lady. She heard that the king was going to kill all the Jewish people. So she was brave and she decided she's going to approach the king and tell him, "I am a Jew. Please save my people." And that's what she did. She gave basically her life. I mean, the king could have killed her. He could have said, "No, I'm not going to listen to you." But she stood up, went before the king and said, "King, please save our nation." And guess what? The king saved the nation because of her bravery.
That is so true. So cool. And if you look at it, even Mordecai, he was a kind of a hero too. How do you think Mordecai was a hero in the story of Esther?
Well, I think that Mordecai was a hero because he saw the future in Esther, and he knew the destiny that was inside of her, and he encouraged her. And in the end, she was courageous.
That's right.
So who would you say could be heroes in our lives?
A star.
A star?
Yeah, like a star. You know, people think like actors and sports people are stars, so they can be good heroes.
Mm-hmm. Firefighters.
Firefighters. Oh, that's a really good hero.
That's a good one.
Saving people.
Huh? Saving people.
Yeah. I think even like our leaders and pastors.
Mm-hmm. I think teachers are heroes.
Never a teacher. I'm just joking.
So is there anything we could maybe share with everybody watching that's maybe struggling to find out who a hero is to them?
You know what I think, Pastor Michelle? Every person can be a hero.
That's right.
Because God has created every person special with something to give in this world. And if you have courage to do what is right, you can also be a hero.
Be a hero. You know what? After listening to all of you speaking, I really believe God has such a plan for each and every person, and they have a hero right now in their midst.
That's right.
Yes.
Pastor Pam, would you pray for everyone that's watching? Maybe Absolutely. They're just struggling a little bit today.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you that we can come into your presence freely today. And Lord, I thank you that you sent your son Jesus to be a hero for the world. And so, Lord, we thank you that we can be heroes for you. That, Lord, we can be a hero by spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ to those who don't know. We can be a hero by helping people. And Lord, we just ask that you would help us to find that hero within us as we look to you, our greatest hero. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Wow. So this has been such an amazing interview, because you know what, kids at home, you can have a hero just like Pastor Sam and Pastor Pam. Your mom and dad might just need one of those Thor hammers as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we want to say thank you to this amazing family for being here with us today. And I hope you come back again soon. Will you come back?
We
Absolutely.
Will.
You want to say bye?
Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone.
Wow, what an amazing Sunday today. Just to learn about Esther, such a woman of faith. And I mean, she was never meant to be a queen, yet God gave her that opportunity to be able to save all the people that she served.
That's correct. And so she was really a hero of faith. And because of her life, people's lives were changed. In the same way with us, because of our lives, people's lives can be saved and changed as well.
I really believe each and every one of us and everybody watching has been born for a time such as this. It's time for us to stand up. It's time for us to shine for Jesus. And it's time for us to make a change in the world that we are involved in.
Very true.
So I think we should really pray for each and everyone watching today, that we can become like Esther, a hero of faith, but in our own community, in our own home, in our own area, and with the friends that we have.
And with the plan that God has for each one of us. Because no matter who you are, God has a special plan for you.
You weren't born by mistake. You were born for a purpose. And God has a plan. And we're going to pray that God is going to reveal to you what your plan is for your life. So shall we all stand up together? And I think it would be really nice if we put our hands on our hearts. Because today we're really trusting God that He will show the plan of our own lives and lead us in the right way. So let's just commit everything to the Lord. Let's pray for ourselves. And Father, right now, we just pray for every person watching today. God, we thank you that just like you gave Esther a purpose and a plan, we thank you that each and every one of us watching this today knows what their purpose and plan is. God, I pray that we will be changers in the world that we are involved in. Lord, may we be a light to those that are around us. God, may you give us visions and dreams of where you are taking us to. And Lord, may we not be scared to speak up. May we be just like Esther, bold and brave, knowing God, you are going before us no matter what we face. We honor you today, Lord. We thank you for the perfect plan in place for our lives. We give you the glory and we say, Lord, have your way. Do with us as you want, Lord. Show us where we need to change things. Help us, guide us, and watch over us. We give you the honor and the glory today. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, God, that each child was not born by mistake, but they were born with a purpose and a plan. And we thank you, God, that the plan of the enemy shall not stand against them anymore. But Father, you will rise them up right now so that they can stand strong and bold for you. In the mighty name of Jesus we pray.
Amen.
So I'm excited. We have had three incredible heroes. Mm-hmm. Heroes of faith. So let's go come back next Sunday and see who's our last hero.
Good idea.
So I'm looking forward to that. We shall see you next week.
Okay. Bye.